I do like to party, though. And in college, I was what you call, not an English major, an alcoholic, I think is the right word for it. And I really love costume parties. Halloween is my favorite. One year, my friend and I decided to go dressed as Bert and Ernie. I was Bert. I had the yellow face, the unibrow, the works. She didn't tell me at the last minute that she found out the guy she liked was going to be at the party, so she changed her mind and showed up as a sexy kitten instead. So I show up to the party, just Bert, just a lonely, yellow, sexually ambiguous Muppet. People were coming up to me all night and they were like, so what are you, some sort of pineapple person? I don't get it. So the next year, I decided to go as something a little more sexy. So I dressed as a cowgirl, and I wore all my clothes backwards. I was reverse cowgirl. It was a good thing. Yeah. Thanks. If anyone wasn't sure, you can explain it to the person next to you. Or show them later tonight, you know? Whatever works for you. I think I am getting to the point in my life where I need to give up one night stands. I'm not very good at it. Last week, I tried to sell some bedroom furniture on Craigslist, and I posted one night stand. 20 bucks. I got more responses than I ever did on eHarmony. It was amazing. I almost had a one night stand. I was talking to a guy in bars last week. He's buying me drinks all night. At the end of the night, he was like, hey, babe, you should come back to my place. And when he called me babe, I realized he didn't know my name. So I didn't go home with him. I was really proud of myself. Told my roommate the next morning, and she goes, let me get this straight. Your only criteria for going home with this guy is if he knew your full name? And I was like, no, just my first name. That's all I wanted. One of the worst one-night stands I ever had. I woke up the next morning to see that the guy had very neatly folded my clothes and placed them on the dresser. I think I would have rather woken up and just have there be blood everywhere. Because I don't know what kind of crazy Norman Bates shit this guy's capable of. You know what I mean? The worst one-night stand ever didn't happen to me. It happened to my best friend. She told me immediately afterwards. She woke up. She and the guy were both blacked out drunk. She woke up to him taking a dump on the floor next to the bed. Then he got back in bed, went back to sleep. Didn't even know he did it. So she leaves immediately and calls me on her way home. And I had to point out to her, hey, Allison, you realize that if he doesn't remember taking the dump and you left... he's gonna think you did the dump and run. So she's freaking out. She's like, oh my God, you're right. What do I do? I have to do something. I was like, yeah, what are you gonna do? Go back and leave him a note? Put a sticky note on his door that just says, hey buddy, floor poop, your poop. Just wanna clear that up. Yeah, she's screwed. You can't get out of that.